Within the transition metals topic, we're going to look at catalysts and start off with a little bit of revision. So the two points that they're often want to know is what a catalyst is and how it works. So it's something which is unchanged in a reaction, and it provides an alternative reaction route, and essentially that has a lower activation energy. We can show this with an energy profile diagram. So in an energy profile diagram, the y-axis is enthalpy, and then the x-axis, a lot of students put that down as time, but since the time is so short in a reaction generally, it's probably more sensible to say it's sort of like the reaction progress. I put the reaction pathway, you'll sometimes see it as reaction coordinate. So as we go from left to right, it's just the progress of the reaction. If I put my reactants there, and for this reaction, I'll put my products down here. So we can see that my products have got lower enthalpy than my reactants. So we're looking at an exothermic reaction. And from the reactants to the products, you can see there's a decrease in energy, and that is our enthalpy change. So that will be negative change. So for the reaction pathway, so this is the reaction route that we'd normally show for the reaction. So despite it being exothermic and a decrease in energy, we need to put some energy in, break some bonds to get that reaction working, and we can see here is the activation energy for the uncatalyzed reaction. If we use a catalyst, this will change the route of the reaction, and we can see that now, essentially, the activation energy is lower. It's also important to note that the enthalpy change is unaffected by the use of the catalyst, so it's just the activation energy which is brought down. Another bit of revision, reminding ourselves how catalysts are involved with a Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution. Let's label the axes again. So on the y-axis, we're looking at number of molecules, number of particles, and the distribution of their energies. So we'll have energy on the x-axis. If we draw our distribution, so just for a general sample, we can see just a few features of the distribution. So the distribution starts at the origin, so none of the particles have zero energy, and then of low energy, we have a lot of our distribution with low energy, so this is the most probable energy that our particles have. And then when we get down to the high energy, so tapers off but doesn't come into contact with the x-axis, so we're not putting a limit on the amount of energy that we might have, but we've got very few particles with very high energy. Now you might remember that we'd say that the activation energy somewhere down to the right there, and this would be the activation energy for the uncatalyzed reaction. So this is that purple pathway that we put down in the energy profile diagram. And we can see that for the uncatalyzed reaction, we have only a very small proportion of the molecules have an energy which is great enough for them to successfully react. However, with the catalyzed pathway, we're bringing down the activation energy. That's that orange pathway. So we'll draw our activation energy of much lower energy, and we can see the consequences that we get far more of our molecules which are now able to successfully react.